Hi students, welcome to my channel Learn with Tanya. Today we are going to discuss a major topic from computer organization and architecture, that is instruction cycle. Here we discuss how processor execute the instruction, which step follow and all. There is also a clear flow diagram to understand the instruction cycle. In previous video I share a detail about instruction. If you want to understand the concept behind the computer instruction, then watch the last video so that you can understand the about instruction cycle easily. You can find the link on description box or my playlist directly. So let's start with instruction cycle. Before that, first we will discuss about a common term, program. What is program? Program are the set of instruction for a processor to execute a problem. Means program is a set of instruction to execute a problem. This program store in the memory unit. Processor read the program from the memory unit and execute with the help of instruction cycle. Each instruction in a program are executed by using instruction cycle. Again, each instruction cycle consists of four phases, like fetch instruction from memory, decode the instruction, read the effective address from the memory, and execute the instruction. Those phases are work in a loop form, so it is known as cycle or instruction cycle as shown in the figure. Before that, we will discuss about some terms which is used in instruction cycle. First one is MAR. Or memory address register. It is the address line through which it can transfer the address value of data from memory unit to register. Next one is MBR, memory buffer register. It is the data line through which it can transfer the actual value of the data. Means whatever the value is stored in memory or what is the current value present in the memory transferred through the data line. It also called as memory data register. Next, program counter. It holds the address of the next instruction to be fetched, and it also count the instruction which are already executed. Last is instruction cycle. It holds the instruction. Whatever the instruction is given by the user is stored in the instruction register, which is present in CPU. So start with our own topic, different phases of instruction cycle. Fetch and decode. Fetch means to load an instruction from memory into a CPU register. Means processor reread the instruction from memory which is given by the user. Then it convert into machine level language which is called as decode. Initially program counter is loaded with the address of first instruction. In that first stage, the sequence counter is 0 at the time of T0. After each clock pulse, sequence counter increase 1 by 1. Means before the execution process start, the sequence counter is initially 0. After increment of sequence counter value, the time signal also increase to T0, T1, T2 and so on. From the below step, we understand how fetching is done. After starting the program, initially sequence counter is as usual 0. At the time of T0, whatever the data are present in program counter, it transfer into address register, which is named as AR. Again, during the T1 clock pulse, the data present in AR transfer into IR through memory address register, and the IR hold the opcode. And the program counter value will increase. Means PC equals to PC plus 1. At T0 and T1 clock pulse, the fetching process is done. Then it goes for decode on next clock pulse. Means here T2 clock pulse used to decode the instruction. It decode the instruction register. The opcode bit present in 12 to 14 bit are decoded. And the address register present in 0 to 11 bit are also decoded, which is present in D0 to D7. And the addressing mode, which is present in 15th bit, also decoded. If it is 0, then it is a direct addressing mode. And if it is 1, then it is a indirect addressing mode. Again, during the next clock pulse T3, it make a decision what the instruction is in which format, like memory reference instruction, register reference instruction, or input-output reference instruction. It reads the effective address from the memory. Then the instruction is executed. All the steps are mentioned in a flowchart. So let's check the flowchart. At the starting point, sequence counter is equal to 0. In the next step, at the time of T0 clock pulse, the program counter placed in address register. Means whatever the information present in program counter transfer into address register. Again, at the time of second clock pulse, T1, the memory address register or MAR placed into IR, and the value of PC will be increased. Till T1 clock pulse, the fetching process is done. Next, we will go for decode. So, what you have to decode? Whatever the value present in opcode address field will decode it. So, first the opcode has been decoded. Whatever the value present in 12 to 14 bit has to be decoded to find what operation to be done. And the 15th bit of I value is present. Whether I value is 0, it is a direct addressing mode, or I value is 1, it is a indirect addressing mode. And the address value present in 0 to 11 bit is also decoded. So, the opcode value present in instruction register or 12 to 14 bit is decoded to perform the operation. And the address value present in AR or 0 to 11 bit is decoded, and the I value is also decoded and at the same clock pulse. After decoding, we have to execute the program. So now coming to the next step. Before executing the step, we should check whether I value is direct or indirect. We must check the value of D7 also. If the value is 12 to 14 bit data, it starts from 000 to 111. Means D0 equals to 000, D1 equals to 001, D2 equals to 010, and so on. So D7 equals to 111. It represents 1. If the D7 equals to 1, then it is the register reference instruction or input-output reference instruction. If D7 equals to 0, then it is a memory reference instruction. If the instruction goes under memory reference instruction, it have all the value of D0 to D6, like 000, 001, 010, and so on. First, we decide the instruction is in which format. Then we go for the decision step. There is a condition given to check I value, means the 15th bit, if it is direct or indirect addressing mode. If it is 0, nothing to do. Directly we have execute the memory instruction and make a sequence counter value is 0. After execution, again the cycle will start from T0. But if I equals to 1, then we convert the effective address which is present in MAR into AR. Then we execute the memory reference instruction and make the value of sequence counter equals to 0. And the loop will continue to T0. Now coming to left side, register reference instruction and input-output reference instruction. Here D7 equals to 111, means 1. Here also, check a condition I value. If the last bit or I value is 0 and the D7 value is 111, means the last 12 to 15 bit value is 0111. Then it execute register reference instruction and set sequence counter is 0. Suppose the last bit is 1 and D7 value is 111. So the last 12 to 15 bit value is 1111. Then it execute input output reference instruction and make the sequence counter 0. Again it goes to T0 to continue the loop or to execute the next instruction.